Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter respiration. In that we are studying topic respiratory quotient. Now when I say respiratory quotient, it means the amount of carbon dioxide evolved and the amount of oxygen used or consumed. Let's try and find out the equation about it. Respiratory quotient. When I say about this, it is defined as a ratio of carbon dioxide molecules that are evolved at various processes to the amount of oxygen that is consumed in the process of respiration. It's basically division of both, amount of CO2 evolved divided by amount of CO2 consumed during this process. Now, when you talk about carbohydrates, that is lactose, another form of sugar, carbohydrates like disaccharides, monosaccharides, polysaccharide carbohydrates, whether it is glucose, lactose, maltose, the respiratory quotient is always 1. Whereas in the case of lipids like fatty acids, other unsaturated or saturated lipids, the respiratory quotient may be less than 1. Even in the case of proteins or polypeptide chain, the respiratory quotient is just below 1. So we can say that carbohydrates produce respiratory quotient which is equivalent to 1 or 1 and which is really high form of energy. That is the reason the calorific value of carbohydrates is much more as compared to proteins and lipids, and they give you more energy or more calorie in the terms to carry down your work. Even more ATP is generated by the breakdown of carbohydrates if you compare simple lipids and simple kinds of fats. No doubt fats give more amount of calories or more kilomole of calories, but carbohydrates have respiratory quotient which is approximately 1. Respiratory quotient. Now, respiratory quotient can be defined as the ratio of molecules of CO2 that is evolved or removed out of the cell to the number of oxygen molecules consumed or used in the process of respiration. For carbohydrates, the respiratory quotient is always equal to 1. Whether you consist of glucose, lactose, fructose, or you talk about the monosaccharides, polysaccharides, disaccharides, all of them, like disaccharide like sucrose, monosaccharide like glucose, or polysaccharide like other carbohydrates. As you can see in the equation, that glucose plus carbon dioxide, what we get is your carbon dioxide molecule, water and energy, and the respiratory quotient changes accordingly. In the case of lipids or fats, we talk about whether it is unsaturated, saturated or polysaturated fatty acids, the respiratory quotient will be less than 1. And it is observed that certain lipids, which could be monosaturated lipids, have the respiratory quotient changing in and accordingly, whether that organic acid has to be broken or it has to be dislocated. Depending upon the requirements, the respiratory quotient may slightly overchange or drift. Whereas in the case of proteins, that is chains of polypeptide, they have a respiratory quotient which is less than 1, much more than less than 1, which is approximately less than 1, approx 0.9 to 0.8. And this is due to the volume of less CO2 evolved during the process of protein metabolism, especially during ammonification, that is protein demetabolism process, less CO2 is involved. And if less CO2 involved, then it will have an effect on the amount of O2 that is used in the process. So students, this was about the respiratory quotient. We did study about the respiratory quotient of carbohydrates, proteins, as well as lipids. Now different enzymes have different respiratory quotient depending upon their requirement. I hope you all are very clear about this concept of respiratory quotient. Thank you.